Hey, what's up? It's Cher, and this is the beginning of my Pieces of Cher documentary. And yeah, so here it goes.
Imagine it tomorrow. It's all when. What would I do? Sometimes it can get really difficult because sometimes I feel like I'm in this bubble. And the saddest part is that I don't actually want that bubble to pop, because the minute that that bubble pops is when it's all over. So, from that moment when I opened my eyes, I realised that I'm never ever going to take any of this for granted.
To think of the future scares me. It really does. Because, of course, I have power over what my future is. I mean, I have choices to be made, and, you know, I play a big part in my future. But just to think that I don't know what it's going to be, that's really scary. But what I will say is, I'm going to work my ass off.
How's it going?
I am just pulling into iHeart in the village, and I'm going on stage in about an hour, so I'm excited.
I think a lot has changed since the last album, Sticks and Stones. I think I have changed the most. I think I've learned a lot more about myself, and I feel a lot more comfortable with myself, and definitely my taste for music and what I want to record has changed. I'm definitely not the little bubblegum princess anymore. There's a lot of things about me that people don't know.
Security for today. Back the fuck up.
I just signed for lots of fans. Standing backstage before I go on to do my show, I go through a list of things in my head. One of the things is to check myself to make sure that I haven't got a boob hanging out or my butt's not showing. And then the second thing is I think positively. I always tell myself that this will be all good. I won't fall over, I'll be fine. But the main thing for me is I don't want to stress myself out before I go on stage. Of course I'm nervous. Everyone and anyone's going to be nervous. If you're not nervous, then you're a crazy person. I don't know what planet you're from if you don't get nervous with a crowd of people out there waiting for you screaming your name. But I know I'm going to go out and have a good time and make sure that everyone else is going to have a good time. I have mixed feelings whenever I step off the stage when I finish a show. I question myself a lot. I step off stage and I'm like, was it good enough? Please God, I hope it was good enough. So I get off stage and I normally say to my manager or my husband, was it all right? Be honest. And they always speak the truth.
Yeah, it's not nice, is it?
Like, it's not the
worst. Can we play that beginning bit again? I'm fine with this. There's going to be people here, right?
I have 100% involvement in everything that I do. The team is the most important part of what I do, because if the team doesn't work, then I don't work. You know, if my team aren't preparing things for me and making sure that everything's okay so I've got the tools to do my job, I mean, it's the most important thing. You know, I can't go on stage with a band that I'm not comfortable with. I can't go on the road with a tour manager that I'm not comfortable with. So it's definitely important, and I think you grow as an artist and the people around you grow as well. And that's what makes it so nice.
Where do I put it? In a little bucket?
The hardest thing about being on tour is the possibility of getting sick. I hate that. I hate waking up in the morning and feeling really groggy and just knowing that my show isn't going to be the best that it's going to be.
But who's your favourite now?
You! Yeah, that's
what I'm talking about.
It would be the worst possible feeling for me for someone to go out on the stage and say, oh, she's not performing. I'd feel like an absolute arse, is what I'd feel like. Because all them people turning up, they want to see me, and I'm just not showing up. That is so not me. Never.
Yeah, check that out.
And then
yeah, we have
I have the tuxedo and the bow tie.
The feeling that I get when I know that my work will be revealed and released and listened to, I feel very proud. I'm very proud of my work. You know, when I worked real hard on it and it's exactly what I wanted. But I think the one thing that makes me really curious and I think a lot about this is the thought that someone, somewhere, will be listening to one of my songs. This is Ronnie and he plays the keyboards. And sometimes he messes up.
Sometimes.
But we're just being honest.
I guess.
And sometimes we say that if Ronnie messes up, then he has to pay for food. This is John, and he plays guitar. Yeah. Very, very good at it too.
Try.
This is Rob, and Rob is John's brother, which I think is really, really cute, that we have family members within our group. And I don't really have much more to say about that.
Plays drums.
Besides the fact that he plays drums, and personally, I think Rob is the bestest drummer.
So nice, so kind.
Bestest. It feels amazing to know that the album is done. And I think the main reason for that is knowing that it's exactly what I wanted. And it took a long time. And it's been stressful, it's been tiring, and then again it's been really fun too, because you know, the whole experience of going into a recording studio and trying to get the best take, that's amazing to me. I love being in a studio, so it's been really, really good. But I have been very frustrated because my fans didn't get the album when I wanted them to have the album. But it's about time, and now is the time.
Not bad at all, guys.
When you put your clothes back on.
Have you been filming this whole time?
Brody shower. Yes. Fresh and clean. Yes. Brody shower. Yes.